Hey everybody, so I'm back to do a tutorial on the look I was wearing in a past recent video. The name slips my mind right now. I think it was my Cure Natural Aqua Gel review video, but regardless, it was a very requested look. I told you all I would have a tutorial done for you, and here it is. I'm pretty excited to finally play around with my sugar pill shadows and come up with something that I assume that you guys like since it was so requested. But regardless, you can use whatever products you have. If you're interested in seeing how I did this look, then please stay tuned. As always, I'm starting with my primer to prevent creasing and to keep my shadows lasting all day. Then I took a light brown eyeshadow with a fluffy brush and blended this into my crease. It's just a matte brown shadow, and this is going to act as a blending color and a transition color, so when we blend colors later on, it'll be super easy. And then I took a white cream base, apply this all over the remaining section of my lid that has no shadow on it, and I blended it out with a clean finger into my inner tear duct and lash lines before applying a matte white shadow on top of the base. Just with a patting motion, I'm applying the shadow onto the center of my lid and outer portion of my lid, keeping the inner corners clean, and I'm just packing it on and blending it towards my crease. Then going into my Sugar Pill Burning Heart palette, I'm taking Butter Cupcake, which is a matte, vibrant yellow color, and I'm applying this onto the inner one-third of my lid, dragging it a bit upwards and down onto my lash line before going in with a crease brush and the vibrant purple, which is Poison Plum. And I just took my time and slowly worked the color into a V formation from my lash line into my crease. And after packing the shadow on, I took a clean blending brush and started to blend this color out. Now, this is the most rigorous part of the whole tutorial. You have to take your time and really blend this color. Even though these shadows do blend super easily, just make sure you blend it to the sections that you need the color to be in, which is into your crease and on the outer corner. Don't go over the white too much. And after you're satisfied with your blending, drag the same color onto the outer half of your lower lash line before highlighting your brow bone with the matte white shadow. I focused the majority of the color on the highest point of my brows, and I just blended everything out with a couple blending brushes. Made sure everything was nice and smooth before lining my eyes how I usually would with just any liner. I used liquid and line it however you typically line your eyes. I usually make a nice little wing. La 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 la. Still making my wing. And I applied a black pencil liner to my lower lash line. And you can leave the eyes like this if you want it all matte. I think it looks great all matte, or you can just add a little pop of shimmer into the middle portion. I just applied a little bit of glitter adhesive. Then I applied some glitter on top of the adhesive when it was still wet onto the center portion where the white shadow is. And I dragged it a little higher because from far away it looks a little better when it's dragged up higher. Up close it looks kind of funky. But then I applied some fluttery glamorous lashes to complete the look. Applied a little bit of mascara, and then the eyes are pretty much done. Now moving on to the cheeks. Let's have a nice natural peachy matte cheek. So I used this Jane blush in Blushing Petal and just applied this almost where you would contour your cheeks, but a little bit higher, just directly on the cheekbone, and blended it out before going in with a highlighter, which is a shimmery skin tone sheer golden glow type of highlighter, and I apply this with a stippling brush above my cheekbones and down the bridge of my nose just to give a glamorous glow to our completed face look. And now onto the lips, I'm going with a neutral pinky brown lip color. And I topped it off with a shimmery pinkish brown, very similar color, but in lip gloss form. Just add a little shine to the lips, and that is the finished look. So that completes our tutorial. I hope you guys enjoyed this look. Thank you guys as always for watching. Please comment, rate, and subscribe, and I will see you guys in a later video.